Thunderbird put on his Sunday best war outfit to let me see him, and he was splendid to look at, with his face painted red and bright and intense like a fire coal, and a valance of eagle feathers from the top of his head all down his back. And he had his tomahawk, too, and his pipe, which has a stem which is longer than my arm, and I never had such a good time in an Indian camp in my life, and I learned a lot of words of the language. And next day Bibi took me to the camp out on the plains, 4 miles, and I had another good time, and got acquainted with some more Indians and dogs. And the big chief, by the name of White Cloud, gave me a pretty little bow and arrows, and I gave him my red sash ribbon, and in 4 days I could shoot very well with it, and beat any white boy of my size at the post. And I have been to those camps plenty of times since, and I have learned to ride, too. Bibi taught me, and every day he practices me and praises me, and every time I do better than ever he lets me have a scamper on Soldier Boy, and that's the last agony of pleasure, for he is the charmingest horse, and so beautiful and shiny and black, and hasn't another color on him anywhere, except a white star in his forehead, not just an imitation star, but a real one, with 4 points, shaped exactly like a star that's hand-made, and if you should cover him all up but his star, you would know him anywhere, even in Jerusalem or Australia, by that. And I got acquainted with a good many of the 7th Cavalry and the Dragoons and officers and families and horses in the first few days, and some more in the next few and the next few and the next few, and now I know more soldiers and horses than you can think, no matter how hard you try. I am keeping up my studies every now and then, but there isn't much time for it. I love you so, and I send you a hug and a kiss. Kathy. P.S. I belong to the 7th Cavalry and 9 Dragoons. I am an officer, too, and do not have to work on account of not getting any wages.